Leaders from ASEAN countries and President Park Geun-hye adopted a joint statement today at the Korea-ASEAN Commemorative Summit.
A big part of that statement outlines a set of agreements aimed at bolstering their economic, cultural, and social ties. For our first story, here's our Hwang Seung-hee.
Noting that the launch of the ASEAN Economic Community next year will become a new growth engine for the global economy, leaders of South Korea and 10 Association of Southeast Asian Nations agreed to bolster economic cooperation. In a joint statement following the Korea-ASEAN Commemorative Summit on Friday, the leaders vowed to work towards swift negotiations for additional liberalization of the Korea-ASEAN Free Trade Agreement.
이를 위해 2015년 말까지 목표로 하고 있는 한 아세안 FTA 추가 자유화 협상의 순조로운 진행과 무역 원활화 및 제도 개선을 통해 현재 1,350억 불의 교역 규모를 2020년까지 2,000억 불로 확대키로 하였습니다.
President Park Geun-hye promised to simplify visa regulations for Southeast Asians entering Korea from the first day of 2015 and noted a new deal on two-way consular cooperation.
또한 양측은 인적 교류 연 700만 시대를 맞아 관광객, 기업인, 정부 인사, 유학생 그리고 근로자 등 양측 국민에 대한 영사 협력을 강화해 나가기로 하였습니다.
The South Korean leader outlined Seoul's commitment to share its experiences with the so-called Semaul movement, which is an initiative that dates back to 1970s and is credited with helping modernize the nation's economy. She also vowed to invite about 100 people from the science and engineering fields each year for training programs in Korea. And to carry out these projects, President Park said South Korea will increase its contribution to the ASEAN-South Korea Cooperation Fund by $2 million U.S. to $7 million starting next year. Hwang Seung-hee, Arirang News, Busan.